Foundation, and I'm in shade 3. I use the Sephora 64 Pro Foundation brush. Looks like that. Foundation's pretty light coverage, but it is buildable, so you can do a second layer if you need to. But that was kind of the whole reason why I got this one, was because it was lighter coverage. Basically the base, it's kind of building up around my nose right there. So I'm just gonna take this brush. There we go. Yeah, that's the base basically. Then I will take the Coty Airspun Loose Face Powder, and this is the Naturally Neutral shade. I actually don't like this powder, but I'm still using it right now, so I'll just put that under my eyes to set the concealer. I definitely don't like using a lot of this powder because it's so powdery. And so it can like look very dry very fast. And I'll put it on my forehead, in the center, kind of anywhere that if it like gets really shiny throughout the day. So I make sure like this area gets powder because that part gets pretty oily. Chin. And then I will set a little bit of my cheeks just because I'm about to put another powder on my face and I don't want it to move the foundation around. Obviously looking very flat and powdery and dry, but it's part of the process. Okay, so then I take the L'Oreal True Match foundation powder, and it's in the shade W7. This is not probably the right shade for me, but it's what I have, so. And I'm taking the Bare Minerals Full Flawless Face Brush. And I just start working it into the cheeks very lightly and in circular motions. Contour brush, Maybelline Fit Me Blush at 30 in Rose. Powder, and I'll get like that much on my sponge, and I'll just drag it across like that. Maybelline Brow Define and Fill Duo, and it's in the shade Deep Brown. Looks like this. just gonna lightly fill in just to help with the shape. The setting spray to get rid of the powdery look and to like help everything kind of melt in and mesh together better. Otherwise it's just gonna look like there's makeup sitting on top of my skin. So next I'm gonna highlight, and I use the Morphe M438 brush. I had a different brush, but this is the one I use currently. It works just fine, but there was another Morphe brush I used and I lost it at my wedding, so. I used the Jeffree Star 24 Karat Gold palette for highlighting, and I used the shade Sarcophagus. It's the only shade I really use. Sometimes I'll use King Tut, but I use the shade Sarcophagus. And then I will lightly highlight the top of my cheekbones because this palette is very pigmented, so I'm like lightly doing it, and you can see it's like super bright. Then Cupid's bow, and just highlight my inner corners. Then I use the Benefit Bad Gal Bang mascara. This one's kind of old. Wipe my hands. lips. So, like I said, you can still kind of see blemishes through, but that is, I'm growing to like that because I like that I can see my skin and it's more natural. Yeah, pretty fresh and yeah. Then we'll do my hair if I have time. Okay, so I got dressed. I'm just gonna brush my hair out. Secret Defeat Bounce Powder Brush. French Lavender Honey Mist from Bath & Body Works. Hair is done, makeup is done, outfit is done. You can see it. That's what I'm wearing. And yeah. Okay, so now I'm just gonna get my stuff together to go. So I might have some oatmeal when I get to work. But it's the Whole Foods Greenade apple celery spinach kale lemon juice. And then coffee too when I get to work. Alright, put some lip gloss on. And then got my bag together. Lunchbox juice. So I am headed out now. Headed to work. So I hope you guys enjoyed what a morning looks like with me on a workday. By no means is this a routine. This is just what happened today. So thanks for coming along, and I hope you guys enjoyed. Please like this video and hit subscribe if you're not already, and I hope you guys enjoy y'all's day. Bye.